What happened on 14 February 2019 is still fresh in the nation's memories. Forty CRPF personnel were killed after a suicide bomber rammed his explosive-laden vehicle into their convoy. It's been 12 months since, and the National Investigation Agency, which is probing the case, has failed to unearth the conspiracy behind the deadly attack. Also, the charge sheet hasn't been filed as yet. In June, 3 months after the attack, Union Minister of State for Home G. Kishan Reddy had said the conspirators, the suicide bomber, and the one who provided the vehicle have all been identified. But till date, that is all we know, nothing more. Adil Ahmed Dar, a local from Pulwama, was the suicide bomber who rammed into the convoy. Along with him, other JEM operators Mudassir Ahmed Khan, Kari Mufti Yasir, Kamran and Sajid Ahmed Bhatt were the main suspects. And all of them were killed in different encounters over last 1 year. With the suspects having been killed, what remains to be traced now is the source of heavy explosives. How did the perpetrators manage to sneak such heavy explosives into Pulwama? We don't know whether the explosives were smuggled from across the border or secured internally. According to various reports, one thing is clear. The NIA learnt that the explosives packed inside the car were ammonium nitrate, nitroglycerin and RDX. Today, on the first anniversary of the deadly attack, a memorial was inaugurated in Pulwama's Lethpora area. Memorials are built in commemoration of martyrs. But one more question that begs an answer is, doesn't this memorial remind the country of its inability to prevent the attack?